welcome you all for the first session of second year civics. As first, I want to congratulate for you for this academic year. And academic year, in this year, we are going to deal with the 12 chapters in the civics. Actually, the civics, it is known, popularly known for the political science. Who knows about that? What is the political science? The political science is nothing but a science which deals with the politics. As the development has taken into consideration how the people has got the education, they need the development. And this development, all the round development can be taken place only with the political aspects into the society for the survival of human beings. Already we have discussed in the first year, we know about all the basic concept, how the evolution of the state has came into the existence, and what the importance has been given for the state, for the formation of nationality, nationalism, and equality has been came into the existence, and this equality has arisen for the recognition of a nation, which is known as a nationality for us. In the previous year, we have already discussed about the constitution also. What is a constitution actually? It is nothing but a set of rules and regulations. Before starting a new concept, before starting a new chapter for you, first I want to introduce for you about the syllabus in this academic year, what we are going to discuss. We are going to have 12 chapters are there in this academic year, out of which the 6 chapters we are dealing with our country India, the political concepts like Indian constitution, fundamental rights, fundamental duties are there, directive principle of the state policy, union government, and our statutory bodies are there. In order to see interviews whether the rights of the human beings are given to us or not. In order to protect us, statutory bodies also has came into the existence in order to provide all type of rights to the women into our Indian society. The remaining the next 3 chapters we are going to discuss about the Telangana region, as how the Telanganites has taken a struggle in order to for the merger of Telangana from the Andhra. What are the aspects were taken the constitution, what were the causes, environmental struggles, how the political parties has came into the existence, how the Telanganites, that is our Telangana region people, how they have been participated in order for the merger of Telangana region. And the remaining 3 chapters we are going to discuss about the competitive world issue and smart governance, and we are going to discuss about the India and the from the other world, that is the other countries, that is the recognition, that is the international recognition which is necessary for our country India, that is United Nations Organization. Now we'll start a new concept, that is our Indian constitution. This is a constitution, is not a new concept for us. We know about that. Constitution is nothing but it is a set of rules and regulation. When we are talking about the set of rules and regulation, why it is needed for us? In order to go in a path, we need that the rules and regulations should be followed, and we should know about what type of rights are there, what is going on in our society, which is needed for the development of us and others into the society. When we are talking about the Indian constitution, first we will look about the historical concept, how the deliberative bodies has came into the existence, and what were the process were taken in the constitution, what the historical concept, that historical backgrounds were taken into the constitution by the freedom fighters, and in order to make up Indian constitution, that is nothing but it is known as historical concept. When we are talking about the historical concept of our country India, we know that India got independent in 1947. After a long period of time, a long period of struggle with the Britishers, how India has, Indian people, they have been strive for the independence from the Britishers in order to throw out the Britishers from our country. It has taken in 2 parts, violence and non-violence. And when we are talking about the non-violence, we realize, we recognize Mahatma Gandhi. Later on, we go about that. First, we know about the Indian constitution. When we are talking about Indian constitution, we know that Indian constitution, it is a deliberative body and it is the best constitution in the world. Before making our constitution, the constituent assembly was adopted, were established, and it was headed by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and the constituent drafting committee was set up, and it was headed by by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. In order to provide equality, liberty, fraternity to the Indian society and to eliminate all the socio-economic inequalities which was created by the Britishers during the period of Indian National Movement. And we are going to discuss in this chapter how many 2 years, 11 months and 18 days it has been taken for our great freedom fighters in order to make our Indian constitution. For that purpose, we are saying that Indian constitution, it is a deliberative body. That means it has taken a long period of discussion. A deliberation was made, then later on it was put in front of the new country, India. When the India was known as a new country, when we got independent in the year 1947, after making of our constitution, we have tried in order to provide all type of equality, fraternity and liberties to the Indian society which was taken by the Britishers. In the detail we are going to discuss in this chapter. And this chapter, the weightage of this chapter for the examination point of view, it is for the 20 marks. It is divided into 10. Then the concept what we are dealing today about Indian National Movement, it comes for the 10 marks. It comes for the 10 marks. That means what are the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. Before knowing for the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement, first we will go to what aspects were taken into consideration in the Indian National Movement. And Indian National Movement, it took place between 1857 to 1947 when India was trying in order to take out the Britishers from our country. That means Indians want whatever for the repressive rules were taken, measures were taken by the Indian, by the Britishers on the Indian people. And for that purpose, this period of time has taken a depth root in our Indian society. Whenever we are recalling about the freedom fighters, we know, we realize about what they have been sacrificed. Many of the freedom fighters, they have lost their life in order to achieve the independence to our country, India. Like in the year 1857, the first war of independence, which was took place in the 1857, it also has marked a depth in the Indian society. That means whenever we are learning about the political aspects into the historical concept, then we are recognizing this Indian National Movement. And during that time, the Indian National Congress was one of the most political, important, most political party which has came into the existence. And Dr. Pratapi Ramaiah, he has said that when we are observing the history of Congress, that means now it is known as a Congress party, but during the time of Indian National Movement, it was known as Indian Congress Party. What it was known as? Indian Congress Party. And he has observed that whenever we are learning about the history of the Congress Party, we are learning about the history of Indian National, the Indian National Movement, how the Indian peoples has participated in order to get our country free from the Britishers. These are the important points which we are going to discuss in the Indian National Movement, where how the people of our country India has tried in order to have the independence and throw out all the repressive measures which was taken by the Britishers, in order how they have been exploited. Economically they have exploited for us, socially they have been exploiting for us. The inequalities were created. The Britishers, they have saw the zero of divided rule policy, in which what had happened, our country was divided into two parts on the basis of cultural value. That means our religious, on the basis of the religious only, the Indian society was divided. Now we will discuss about causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. The freedom fighters, those who are the freedom fighters which has participated in India during the time, and they have been participated in order to throw out the Britishers from our Indian society. When we are talking about the causes for the birth of Indian movement, in our historical movement, we realize the freedom fighters, how they have been sacrificed their life in order to achieve the freedom for our country, India. Today we are going to discuss about what were the causes which has inspired the Indian people to throw out the British rule from our country, India, which has taken a negative impact and the Britishers, they have been implemented a developmental policies, but it was not benefited for our country, Indian people. The first is a British colonial rule. When we are talking civilization and this colonization, it has the two impact. That was a positive impact and a negative impact. First, we talk about the positive impact. The positive impact of the British India was that the introducing of the Indian Civil Services, that is the ICS, and the Judicial Panel Court was the Indian Panel Court. Criminal law was organized by the Britishers. It was a sign of development. And apart from that, the postage, telegraph, railway system, and the roadways and the railways, it was introduced by the Britishers in order to achieve the development of our country India. But it was not, the fruit of this development was not given for the Indian people rather than the Britishers. When we are talking about the negative impact of the British colonization was ruthless exploitation of natural resources. That means they were taking our natural resources from our country India and transporting to the England. This way they have been exploited our Indian economy. The repressive measures which was taken by the Britishers, it has implemented and forcefully has made the Indian people to have the agitation, and apart from that, to be the part of the Indian national movement. This was the first cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was the British colonial rule. That means the British colonial rule, it has been implemented. It was it has become a cause for the birth of Indian national movement by participating by the Indian people in order for the getting a development, and apart from that, getting the equality in the Indian society. For that purpose, this British colonial rule, it has given a negative and a positive impact in the Indian society. Coming to the second cause for the birth of Indian national movement, it is a socio-cultural renaissance. When we are coming to the cultural renaissance, it has been established during the period of 19th century. When we are talking about the 19th century, we realize the kings, how they have been established the kingdom in order to have the development in one kingdom to the another kingdom. And apart from that, the society during that time, the superstition was more there. This superstition was then allowing the society to become equal. And apart from that, the equality was not given into a society. This social cultural analysis, in order to give the education for the people, in order to get the development, and apart from that, the equality should be given to the Indian society. The Brahmo Samaj, it is a social organization which was established by the Rajaram Mohan Roy. Krishna Mission was there, and apart from that, many of the societies has came into the existence in order to eliminate all the social inequalities. And this social inequality, which was practiced in the 19th century, for example, like sati was there, widowly marriages were not encouraged, and apart from that, parda system was there, and Wahhabi movement was organized in the 19th century. There is a societies for teaching the people the cultural values and the society. That means this equality should be given to the people. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That is a social cultural renaissance. It has been established during the period of 19th centuries by the many of the movements were organized. For example, like Wahhabi movement were there, and the Samaj, which was followed by the Rajaram Mohan Roy. First, it was established in the name of Brahmo Samaj. This was the second cause for the birth of Indian national movement. And the third is a great revolt. When we are talking about the Great Revolt, in the year 1857, thousands of Indian army sepoys, and apart from that, artisans and the small scale industries, they have been combined and they have been formed into a great revolt, as thousands of sepoys were formed in the year 1857. This revolt, it was organized by the Indian society in order to throw out the Britishers from our country, India. And apart from that, they got the nationalist feeling was inserted in the Indian people, in the Indian society. And this particularly, there was a Dalhousie movement was there. And this Dalhousie law, so it has given the organized the Indian society, and they were introducing. The repressive measures were introduced, to which what it was happening, the people were not getting the society. This Great Revolt has produced the many more leaders, like Rani Lakshmibai, Tatya Tope. Many of the rulers, they were inspired by this Great Revolt, which was organized during the period of 1857. It has produced the thousands of sepoys. The sepoys have been participated. That means the artisans has participated, small scale industries, people also, the laborers also, they were organized as a community and they have been revolted against the British rule. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was a Great Revolt which has took place between the period of 1857. The next it is the English education. English education. When we are talking about the English education, the English education was brought in our country India by the Britishers. It has a positive impact into our Indian society in order to westernize our country and westernize the Indian culture by the Western society. For that purpose only the English education was introduced by the Britishers. It has a good impact. But what has happened here? The educated youth of our Indian society, they were realizing the repressive measures, the rules, and whatever the acts was imposed by the Britishers, they were taking the rights of our country, India. They were feeling that the equality was not there, freedom is not there for us. And apart from that, they were realizing the rights of J.S. Mill, like a political writer, he was a political writer. They was inspired by the writing, and they were in the movement that they needs the civilization to be taken into the Indian society. And apart from that, the ideas of rule of law should be introduced, constitutionalization should be given, nationalism should be there for them, liberalization should be there, nationalist movement should be removed from the Indian society. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was the English education. That means English education was brought by the Britishers in our country India in order to bring the civilization, that is a Western civilization should be taken, that is a Western culture should be implemented in our country India. But when it happened here, the middle class, that means educated youth, they were getting the inspired by the writing of the Western political writers, and they want that implementation in our country India. This differentiation was done by only the educated youth of our country India, and this educated youth of our country India, they were giving the education to the uneducated youth of our country India, and they were getting the realization that means they need the rule of law should be there. Rule of law means nothing but all are equal before the law, and apart from that, equality should be given, and this equality should be given in the society for everybody should be there. Nationalism should be there, nationalism should be there, and the constitutionalization also should be given to the Indian society. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement, that is the English education. The next cause for the birth of Indian national movement is the economic exploitation. During the period of British rule in our country, it was known as a British India. During the time, the economic exploitation was more in our country India by the Britishers. Even though the development was taken into our country India by the Britishers, but they were draining our economy from, that means they were taking our economy from our country India to the another, that is England. And economic exploitation was done by the Britishers in the form of collecting the raw material from our country India and exporting this raw material to the England and selling the same product to our country Indian market at a high price. In this way, they have been exploiting our country India by taking the raw material from our country, collecting the raw material from our country India at the cheapest rate, and selling the same product, the finished product in our country India at a high price. The economic exploitation, the one of the economists, Dada Banerjee, during the period of time, he has explained in his book The Great Theory about how the Britishers has been exploiting our country India by taking the economy and transporting the economy from our country India to the England. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement, that was economic exploitation. What was economic exploitation? It's nothing but the taking the economy of our country India, transporting the economy of our country India from our country India to the England. How they have been exploited? They were collecting the raw material from our country India and selling the same raw material for the finished product into the England. After getting the finished product, the same product was sold in our Indian market at a high price to our Indian society. This was another cause for the economic exploitation. The economist Dada Banerjee, he has explained about the exploitation, the ways of exploitation, how the Britishers, they have been exploited our economic position, economy of our country India, in his famous book which was known as Brain Theory. That means the braining is nothing but taking the economy of our country India. That means they are benefiting, they are taking the benefits of our country to the England. The next is the famines and the acute poverty. The famines, which was expressed in the 19th century during the period of 1873, 1875, 1877 and 1895. During this period of time, in which the thousands of the people were starving and they were starving. In order to overcome this famine, this famine has created a position where the poverty was there in our country India. Acute poverty means nothing but not getting an affordable food to the Indian society. During this period of time, the Britishers forcefully, they were collecting the taxes from our Indian society. They was not giving the time for the replacement, they are not giving the time for us to regain our economy. This position was taken into consideration by the Britishers. By seeing these rules also, the Indian society, they become a part of Indian national movement, which was the cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was the famines and the acute poverty. Acute poverty is nothing but the famines if occurs in our society, what will happen? We don't have the affordable food. During the period of time, by giving the Britishers has to give the support to increase our economy. Instead of giving the support, they are doing? They are imposing the taxes. In order to collect the taxes from the Indian people, by forcefully they were collecting the taxes. This has created that the thousands of the people with the starvation where they were dying. By seeing this situation, Indian people, they have become a part of Indian national movement, which was the cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was the famines and the acute poverty, which was taken during the period of 19th century. Next, we coming to the press. What is the press? Press is nothing but the medium of communication. During the period of Indian national movement, the press only was a medium through which, in order to articulate the demands, in order to articulate the needs of the Indian society, was the press. During the time 19th century, many of the journals, newspapers, many of the newspapers were published. Among them, the most popular were Amrit, Bazaar Patrika, Kesari, The Hindu, Navjeevan, Andhra Patrika, etc. These newspapers played an important, crucial role in order for the awakening among the Indian people to get the nationalist feeling among the Indian society. This press was a medium of instructor and a medium of communication to the Indian society to communicate the needs of the Indian society. And this press was taken into consideration. It was taken into consideration in the form of communication. And this communication, many eminent leaders like Motilal Nehru, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, M.K. Gandhi, many of them, they have been contributed. Their contribution in the Indian national movement. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. That was a press. The next is the repressive measures. That is the rules. Repressive means forcefully imposing on the Indian society. However, we know the Britishers, they were imposing their rules in order to get the control. That means the Britishers have to get the control over the Indian society. For that purpose, many of the laws, many of the acts were imposed. Among them, the Gayatri Act and one of the act which was known as the Rowlatt Act, which is also known as Natural and the Revolutionary Time, which was took place in the year 1919. During that period of time, the British government, without giving any instruction to the Indian society, they were arresting to the Indian people. And the Vernacular Act was introduced. They was using the Draconian Act in order to implement the control over the Indian society. The press also, which we are saying, the press is nothing but a medium of instruction and communication to the Indian society. society to communicate about the nationalist feeling, feeling among the Indian society. This also, the press also were under the control of British. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement, that was repressive rule. That means repressive rule is nothing but strictly they was imposing the rules on the Indian society in order to get a control over the Indian society by imposing different types of laws, like Rowlatt Act was there, and the Vernacular Press Act was there, and the Draconian laws which was introduced in order to have the control over the press. This was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. The next and the last, it is a racial discrimination. Racial discrimination, as we know, our country India, where the different types of culture, religious people, races, we are living together as a unity. But during that time, Britishers, when they came to our country India, when they were ruling our country India, they have been divided our country on the basis of racial discrimination. On this basis only, they were giving the people to have their participation into the society, and they didn't have a participation in the political activities. This racial discrimination, which was done on the basis of races also, the Indian society, they needs that they have to come, that they have to get the social equality should be given to the Indian society. That system of direction was introduced in the year 1919. According to this, the discrimination was done against the Indian. That means Indians were discriminated on the basis of racial. And this racial discrimination, which was making a burden to the Indian society, and this discrimination has angered the Indian people against the British rule, which was another cause for the birth of Indian national movement. These are the causes for the birth of Indian national movement, and it was inspired not only in our country India, it was inspired during the time of Second World War. And it was inspired by the other countries also, by seeing this inspiration. Other causes also are there, but these are the most important causes for the birth of Indian national movement. Once again, we recall the points. The first cause, it is the British colonial rule. British colonial rule is nothing but the Britishers have divided our country India in the form of colonies, and this it was implemented in order to get what? In order to get the control over the Indian society, which has played an important role in our Indian society by negative and positive impact also. The next cause is the social culture renaissance, and this social culture renaissance, which has given a great impact in the society to eliminate the social inequalities from our Indian society. Many of the organizations were formed in order to eliminate all the social evil practices in our country India, like sati, widow remarriages were there, pada system was there, Wahhabi movement was there. Many of the movements were taken place in order to teach the civilization in our Indian society. Next, coming to the Great Revolt, which was took place in the year 1819. During that time, the thousands of the Sipahis, that is the Sipahis, are nothing but the people, they are organized into one unit in order to get the nationalist, that means they have been getting the feeling of nationalism, and this nationalism has created them to become, to do a great revolt against the British rule in order to throw out the British rule from our country, India. The next is the English education. English education, of course, you know that English education was brought to our country India by the Britishers. It has brought to our country India in order to get the westernization in our country and educated youth. They were educating to the Indians in order to get the rule of law, nationalism, and apart from that, constitutionalization should be created. And they were saying that equality, fraternity, liberty should be given to the Indian society rather than the Britishers. The next is economic exploitation. What type of exploitation was done by the Britishers? They were collecting the raw material from the India and transporting this raw material to the England, and selling the same product to the Indian market, selling the same product in the Indian market at the high rate. In this way, they have been exploited by Indian society. And apart from that, the small artisans and the small scale industrialists also, they have been forcefully sent to the do only the agriculture rather than the other occupation. During that time period of the economic exploitation which was taken, the economist Dada Banerjee, he has explained about the exploitation of the economy by the Britishers, it was explained in his famous book, which was known as Brain Theory. The next is the famines and the acute poverty, which took place in the 19th century and during the period of time. The famines were occurring. Even though the Britishers was not giving the support to the Indian society, during this survival, during the famines, the poverty was created. Thousands of people were dying due to the starvation. And this position has made the Indian people to form into the Indian National Movement in order to overcome with the repressive measure. The next is the press. Press is nothing but it is a medium of communication, communicating, and apart from that, getting the awareness among the Indian society about the nationalism. And this, many of the journals were there, diaries were there, and they was inspired by the eminent leaders like Motilal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose. Many of the eminent leaders were taking the press as a medium of communication to the India by spreading the messages sending the messages from the one people to the another people. The next is the repressive rule. What is the repressive rule? Overburden, which was created by the British on the India. That means the diarchy system was introduced. And this diarchy system, they were without informing to the Indian society, they were arrested to the Indian people. This repressive measure also a vernacular act which has implemented in the Indian society, it has become as a burden to the Indian people. The last it is a racial discrimination. Britishers have sought a series of divide and rule policy, dividing the people on the basis of racial discrimination. And this racial discrimination was done in order to get the control over the Indian societies. For that purpose, these are the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. It is the most important topic as the examination point of view. It comes compulsory for 10 marks. It will ask for the write the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. That means first we have to write about the introduction about how the Indian National Movement was organized. And apart from that, introduction about how it has taken a violent and non-violent movement, how it was organized during that time, what was the political party was there, Indian National Congress was headed. That means he was a freedom fighter, and apart from that, he was a president of Indian National Congress, that was a Pratapi Ramaiah. He has been observed that when we are learning the history of our country, India, we are learning actually the history of the Congress means we are learning actually about the history of our country, India. The next class, we are going to discuss about the three phases of Indian National Movement.